morning, everyone. My name is Michael Langas, Chief Financial Supervisor at Azure. This is my first time in the Nigerian PowerBI.
So which PowerBI are you working for?
The global one.
Okay, the global one for the Nigerian.
Anyalo, actually is my name. I'm a data analyst of post-cross system.
I'm an accountant. It's new to me. Let's just say this year. I was at the first live event, so we got something like that.
Okay. So we this stuff still.
Yes, good point.
Okay. So now we're looking at air transportation and passengers carrying over the period of time. So from 1970 to now, I think we're looking at 40 years. 40 years. So now, for everything, because we saw that if we bring in too much of data, because now this one is air transportation. If we bring in railway and everything like that, it's really too much for us to do in space of 2 hours. So just let us speak one of them. And sincerely, when I was doing this analysis, I know that Africa is back. Very back. Like, very, very back. The percentage comparison between Africa, sub-Saharan Africa, to different regions of the world is more than 2,000%. More than 2,000%. So infrastructure-wise, there's a whole lot of things that we need to do. So when we do this analysis and we try to do as much as possible live analysis is because some of the things that we personally do might still go out to some of these analysis. So when we do one analysis, it can come back and help you doing your own personal analysis. So this one is from the World Bank. We got it from World Bank. So there are red lines. If you want to get it, you just go to the data.worldbank.org. You get all data that you need concerning the world itself. So we directly send it to you as CSV file. So the first thing we should do is that let's open the CSV file. data.worldbank.org. So now let's open the CSV file that was sent to us. Yes, so can you open the API/U, something like that? Good morning. Good morning. Ken, just come in.
Good morning.
We're already starting, so please can you come in? Yes. So now, is everybody? Now, if you have this, now if you notice, let's look at the data. First of all, you notice that it has all countries, and one of the rules in boundary is that all data must be in the world. So now we're trying to get from this part of the things that will be cleaning off. So all this is first in the rule. So that is one thing that will be cleaning off. Now, if we look at this data, what can we look at? What can we talk about with this data? Can you look at the data in
air transport?
Yes, air transport.
So it's between us probably an airline flying from countries and
other. Okay, so now this one is not the airline itself. This talks about the passengers. Okay. The number of passengers that is carried
in each country.
In each country. The countries. So you get it? Your name is sir?
Okay, Bulu Lai.
So these are just numbers. So we are not dealing with cash. So if you notice now, in PowerBI, we'll not be using the decimal dot number that has to be in cash. So we are looking at just whole number. Yeah, just looking at whole number. So now all these analysis is just what we want to discuss. Because all of the PowerBI, we are just cleaning up, cleaning. And you notice again that in our there is no the dates that we have here is really here. We don't have the month. So and you notice that is for our variance will not be the month of month. Only year of year. So maybe I need to Mark, thank you. Good morning, can you just come in?
Good morning.
So this file is talking about passengers that used whatever kind of airlines in the country, traveled in and out of another country.
Just so simple.
Nigeria shouldn't be that bad. We traveled a lot.
We traveled a lot, but the issue is this. We travel out, but we don't travel in.
But the problem also is, for how long do we have good records? We
give records in Nigeria. What about this?
As a country.
For Nigeria.
For all. This is what about this? Okay, before you came in, we went to the site. There are some countries that have information from the year 1960 to 1969. But when we look at it, if we are saying that in Nigeria, it might still be low, I think it will be low. You know why? Tourism, thank you. Tourism is a big factor when it comes to traveling, air transportation. Okay. Air transportation. And if And we know the country where Nigeria when it comes to tourism is so rude. So that's another thing that will still affect. And I think majorly, we will have more inter-air transportation than actually out and in.
Because I can pull up the site right now that shows all flight accords and
flying.
They all have one of maximum of one that leaves the shores of the country.
So now why we are trying to just do a talk, a little talk about this data is because we know we are expecting to see. But the thing is that we don't know the magnitude of what we are expecting to see. And then it will happen. So because when we start looking at in comparison with all other ones, because we want to focus in Africa. If we start focusing on Africa, and we start looking at it, we might not focus on the events. So if we focus on it, you will really see the percentage difference between different Africa in comparison to the other continents in the world. So we're going to look at it very well. So I want everybody to, everybody have seen this. So now let's look at the second one. So the second one is, this is the second file. Metadata Country API. That is the two files that we're using. The Metadata API. So now the Metadata API. So the Metadata API talks about just the country information. If you notice.
Okay.
Can you look at it? Yes. So now that special number, we'll look at it in PowerBI and see if we need it. But I think the major things we need is the country, the region, the income group, and the table name. The table name, if you look at it, is just the country name. The country name. So we can use it to link. So when we get to PowerBI, the only thing I just change the table name to just country, so it's easier for us to say, okay, fine, I remember this. So these are just the two files that we need to work on. So now we understand the file. We'll be able to do some a little bit gist about it. So now let's go to work. So within now and 10:30, we should be able to build the data and create relationship. We should be able to clean the data in and create relationship. Then we'll go for a break. Yeah. So everybody has open PowerBI. So people who work here, there's something I noticed in this file. Who know what we call BCSV minus 8? Yeah, something stored as let's go to file, let's go to the save as. Or let's go to save as. Let's see what is being saved as. CSV UTF minus 8. Who have seen that?
Yeah,
I've seen that. You've seen that? How does it work?
No, you have seen before.
Yes.
Yes,
it's comma delimited, but it's not the normal comma delimited. So now let's try as possible to always look at this because it affects the data itself. Yes, it affects the data. So it's better for us to save it as the normal CSV. Yes. What happened yesterday while I was still working on this, I was working. I finished, I was doing my analysis, I got everything right, and I did my visualization. You know what I got in 470 billion, then the normal region were having their normal values, then it added everything up. The 470 billion does not have anything linked, does not have name, does not have region, anything. I was like, what is wrong? Once I needed to look at the file that this is your issue, I learned from the source. Sometimes you think it's PowerBI, look at PowerBI, you have solved it. It's from the source. So please let's change it to CSV. Let's do that two files. Change it to CSV.
Just CSV.
Yeah, just CSV, you're fine. So you see CSV command deleted, you're fine. Then save. If it tells you to replace it.
But you still don't have to know the reason between the difference. So
yes, the difference, I needed to bubble it round round. They did not say any reason. They just said just come out of the business. That minus 8 is what I was looking at. Yes. Yes. Okay, so let's open PowerBI. If I want to know the unique, if I want to know if everything has unique value, it has duplicate and everything like that, you go to view, those of you, can you tick the column distribution?
Before tick. We import it, right?
No, I'm in PowerBI. Go to PowerBI.
Okay.
Yes, so it helps you just, instead of you trying to look at and trying to look at anything else, duplicate or anything, you will know you need value and everything like that there will be. So let me PowerBI. So let me bring in my second file. So I'll wait till I bring in my second file.
You can't transpose now. If you transpose now, you are doing something wrong.
As a sister, there's no way that
take up the first three lines.
Yeah, you need to take up the first three lines.
Yeah, promote it.
I mean, so what we are not using promoted area, we are going to promote area. But if you promote area, it means that you are saying that the first rule should be there.
But after taking the first three.
Okay, after taking it, so we promoted. So, let's go. Let's go.
Hello?
So, remove rules, remove top rules. Then it tells you the number of rules. Three. Then you click OK. Okay, come back again. Okay. So now, see what I do. I cancel in my class step, I cancel, and this is what we have. So I'm in home. So that the first thing we need to do when we're looking at this is to first of all remove all these lines off. So if you see, can you see remove rows or in your the viewer interface? See remove rows. Make sure you're in home tab. Oh, have you seen it? So there's a difference. Oh. Yes. Check, go and bring it all now. Tell me to go to Jesus. No, Jesus, Jesus. Yes. Tell me to this area is the first one. Yes, that is the one that I just so just change that one. So that API is now the fact file. The one you name as fact file is the country data. Yes. So anyway, let's move the number of rules, which is 3. After you do that, the next thing you should do is to make sure that the number one will ask country code. You know that all those have to be the errors. So please, take it, go to transform and do that. Transform, you see threshold as errors. So T, use threshold as errors.
Is that the same function on that home? Yes. The place you supposed to as errors?
Yes. So majorly,
it's all the right thing.
Eh?
There's a place you're supposed to write it.
Yes. Do you use it on yours?
Yeah, I want to use that.
Yes, use it. You can let us go. I'll tell you how to go back. Don't worry.
Okay, it's for sure.
Did you work?
Yeah, I did.
Yeah, huh? So now, majorly, we always notice that these two tabs is what we do our transformation of any data. But whenever we now want to add in a column, we use the third tab, which is add column tab. The add column tab is where we do maybe want to add in column, and we're going to be adding the column here. So now, if you look at it now, let's look at data type. Data type, I did operate.
You call this text. Function name, text.
Leave 1960 to 2018. We'll come back to those four data types.
They're all text.
They're all text, which they are correct.
Yeah.
So now, what we want to do now is this. We need to unpivot. But you remember that when we opened it on in Excel, we're looking at B96C really has some numbers of passengers being carried. So let's look at it. Anyway, let's look at 1960, 1961, 1962. Let's look if they have any.
1960 is not
around. No, okay. 1960, go and T 19, T shift T, then delete. Shift T, then delete. 1960 T, click your shift, then T again. Maybe T the second time, you place everything that I said. Then right click. Then remove follows. If you go to even the end, which is the last column, which is 2018, 2018 does not have. So let's look at that data. Go to the head and check 2018. You know, so just remove it. Just remove it.
Is there anybody to check that it's empty, like the column is empty?
Yes.
So maybe by like, maybe it's okay in medium records, and maybe there's one somewhere.
So these are checked, just let me check it. So let me, okay, so let me go up. So we have, let me just start from, okay, so see, so if I just click this journal,
yeah.
This journal just give me the number of passengers, okay, period of time. So you just give me black.
Okay, I'll say he was referring to the fact that if there's a way we can actually pick the column that has no data, where I'm going through each of them.
Yeah.
Okay, is that a question?
I think it's both. He's extended my question.
Okay, so now, do you notice that so I didn't view?
Yeah. Column distribution.
That column distribution. Imagine the column distribution, they're going to tell you everything.
Yeah.
So your point is just right click, right down, then just check it. You just check.
Yeah.
So when you check your unique column, you notice that your unique column is just one. The one is black.
Yeah.
So you know that thing has to be removed.
No, you have the column rules, you have values of them.
Yes.
I think that's what it means. Where you have a mix of black and green.
Yeah, so that's what you have to say. Distribution, right?
So let me check.
Okay, look at this line.
This column code.
The green line.
They are ordered it. The black line is showing black.
Okay,
black.
Okay.
So, exactly.
Why the green line is showing
black? So, you have mix of data, black,
yes.
So, that's true. That's easily, you know.
So, black is black.
Black is black.
Thank you.
Yeah.
So that's the idea of this lab. So everybody's coming in. And one thing about it is that platform wanted to be as interactive as possible. So sometimes you can just chip in one thing that you learned in PowerBI new. So try to have been a whole lot of stuff in PowerBI. And I was like, so many tasks. Just doing so many tasks. So you can create a report. We did a training with the bank, and we tried to create so many reports. I was trying to do like 17 stream reports in one PowerBI. 17 crazy data. So we're just creating more data. So there's a lot of things that we learn in those process. So whenever they put it, and then one just want that stuff to just simplify, just kind of throw it in for so that we also can learn. it helps a whole lot. So that if it becomes more interactive, it's easier for us to even want to come for the next month. Because we are going to the next one. So yes.
Yes, it's fine.
Yes, it's fine.
Okay, so it's open. So
So let me delete my bar. If we notice, what would you do we need to do now? What should we do now? So we move all columns that we don't need.
Transform?
Yes, in transform, what do we do in transform?
Turn columns.
So now we can't do it all. First of all, we have to click the ones that are already clean. So we are clicking country name, country code, indicator name, indicator code. Make all of them, analyze the four first, then you compile those. Analyze the four, go to transform. You see on pivot other columns. On pivot column, on pivot other columns, on pivot only selected column. So click on pivot other columns. Is we can change the attribute in 3 years, the attribute in 3 years. The values, what should we leave as values? Number of passengers, I mean? Okay. Then values is number of passengers.
Number of passengers showing a decimal.
Yeah, it's showing a decimal, so just change it to whole number. Change to whole number, you can leave it as decimal. But when maybe you click for us, when maybe I click fix decimal number, it changes it to the naira and dollar sign.
Okay.
So it attached the dollar, the money currency, it has currency attached to it. Fixed decimal, but normal decimal and no number. The number, why? We can leave it in fixed in decimal because if we are looking at the average, you will still go in decimal. You go in decimal. We can leave it as a whole number. Anyone? Just depends on how you want to do it.
Because there are people you
don't want. Exactly. You don't want to have 0 points. That's why you
people. Let's do that. Once we do something, let's go and click that distribution. Let's check something. Let's check the number of unique countries that we have. Column distribution. It says 29 distinct. Agreed?
Yeah.
So now, let's go to country data. Country data, we've not been before. So the first thing you should do is just use special as headers. That is it, Abi. That will go on. Just use special as headers. We have 263. So we know that there are some things that we have to do here. So now we can tick that column distribution. Okay. Now let's look at which column do you think we don't need? Let's look at it.
The last column.
The
indicator name.
The table name.
Indicator name.
Indicator name.
Other factor, right? Do we need that?
Okay. Oh, I am in country data.
Yeah, okay.
Country data. Let's be in country data.
The special.
The special notes. We don't need it. So can you remove that column? We don't need special notes. We don't need special notes. So let's get to this point. So maybe we remove that special note. You notice that there are some rows that are empty. Mm-hmm. So that we'll be having no. So I think that we cannot use no to work. ARB does not have a region, does not have an income group, but it has a country. So it might bring in an issue. Because when you're there to look at regions, it will bring the data. But if it has number of persons there, it's going to bring it.
Yeah.
But it's going to become a problem. It's going to become a problem. So now, the first thing we should do is this. Let's go to region. Can you see blank?
Yeah.
So let's see blank. It's just like the normal regions that we're supposed to have. The normal regions that we're supposed to have.
So we have not deleted it, we just select it from.
Yes,
yes.
Just
filter
it out.
There's one in flash. That's she said.
Okay. Use first tool as headers and remove the columns and put it.
So the years, that is 1970.
Thank you. now, one thing is that when we are here, the country code, we have country codes. So we need to check if the country codes in FATFA will be the same with the country codes in country. How do we do that? Because we are trying as much as possible so that our FATFA does not have data for the country that it doesn't need to have data for.
We
move blank in country data. But that same country that has blanks can have data in FATFA. So now we need to make sure that the countries that are here should be the data that we have in FATFA for it to work. Or else, if we load in like that, there will become an issue.
Create a relationship, yeah, but there is nothing. His value is not there.
There's no value. There's no unique.
We are saying for countries that we have removed from country data.
Yes.
We need to also remove.
We remove from FATFA.
So we are restricting our analysis to just those
that countries. Has countries and that has the data itself.
The data is no more complete. The results are still there from it now.
No, it's still complex.
Because we have some variables that are not available for some countries, we decided to filter them out. So whatever we are going to do, if I expect, you know, the countries will filter out to have some information with problem knowledge that is to play with.
Okay, so now let's look at this. Anyway, let's go to FATFA. How is it on the end of FATFA?
Because now on the understanding of data analysis,
yes,
to make sense of the numbers.
Yes.
Okay. In making sense, there are probably some data that are not complete.
Mm-hmm.
And because they are not complete, doesn't make them redundant.
Redundant.
Sure, so we need to look for a way to bring them from incomplete status to complete status. To not give us a full
update the regions for those other countries that were missing.
So now,
if you know what is
which
is what they say that from the incomplete status to the incomplete.
Yes. So
that's another way.
That's another way.
If you know the data that should be there, then you can fill it.
Then you can fill it.
If you don't, then you just have to get it out.
Because at the end of the day, in our analysis, I don't want, because it's time. Our vlog where I will just say,
if you can't complete here, at least we can. That can bring about the engagement you want on the
forum.
Exactly. So it's not a question of, we are restricted by time, I understand.
Yes.
That we don't finish it doesn't mean.
Yes, no, we can't finish. Because visualization is allowed in the whole section of the zone. So it's in the whole section of the zone. But in the model, if we take it there, okay, let's just say it.
We are debating, so I don't want to change.
Okay.
So the question is, let's go your route.
Okay.
But we shouldn't discount. So there is another means of knowledge, like
getting the data
and then and making sense of that information.
So now, what we just want to do is this: all those countries that has code, because you notice in our country. I want everybody to as much as follow. In our country, you notice the issue that they have there is that country code has country name. It's correct. But the issue is that they don't have region.
Yeah.
And we know that normally every country supposed to belong to a region.
Yeah.
That's the data we're trying to claim. So we are trying as much as possible to go to FATFA and say, for every country that is there that doesn't have a region, kindly what? Leave. That is the only thing that we are trying to do.
So that when we are doing region analysis,
country, going to do country analysis, that country that has data but does not have a region will not still even show.
Because we filter it out.
Yeah.
in real life, you would go and create another relationship that has all the countries in the world and the regions and then leave
it.
And
leave
the relationship, exactly.
And that is where, see, that is why we now have country data. That's what Band gave us, country data.
But it's not complete. Yeah. Because what they're giving us is why we are taking off those. Because
those things. So the World Bank gave us this to work with. So it's this country data that we're using to work.
Okay.
How to ensure
such a system to be able to for the class now, right? Let us try to work with now.
So now, for all our analysis that we're doing normally privately, all data are always complete. You find it! Okay.
You don't expect to get it right from the world code.
Yes.
So that data is coming incomplete means there is a problem as
the source,
the setup.
Yes.
So what that gives you is it gives you the opportunity to capture it, fix that problem, and ensure going forward you don't have such repetition. It doesn't mean as you move from one stage to the other, you definitely come up with one problem or the other. The other idea is, okay, there's a problem, this is wrong, let's fix it so that it doesn't repeat.
Good.
So I don't want a situation where, okay, because it's not completely correct, let me just discount it. Meanwhile, that problem will continue until somebody is able to take it on and then
fix it. So now, with the data that we have and all reports that we have, what we want to do is this. We just want to merge queries. So now the merge queries is this. We are making these two queries together and we are looking at the country code or the country as the link. So we are saying that for every Afghanistan or Nigeria is right. But wherever this one is not there, please kindly what? Remove. We're just making queries. So but if you are appending query, appending query means that this is row 1 to 10. Appending means that kindly add from row 11 to 15. That is appending queries. But merge means column adding. While append means row adding.
Sorry.
Merge queries. So when you go to home, you see merge queries. Go to home. Can you see merge queries and append queries? So merge query means that I want to merge this and this together, these two files together, but this way, which is column way.
Okay,
yes,
extended
this way. But if I want to append, it means I'm doing it this way.
Okay.
Row base.
So if I have a new year data, I can append to.
I can append to what I. Yeah. Now, if we have a new data,
if you
want
to add data, you can append.
You can append.
Yeah, you can match.
That is the way.
Yeah.
Okay. So let's leave merge queries
on the fact file, right?
Yes, in fact file. So merge queries. So merge queries as new means that can you leave these two files, bring it in as a new query. So
we're in the first option, right?
Yeah, we're in the first option.
We want the first one.
Yes.
Okay. That's just merge.
Yeah, just merge queries. So now let's go to this one. This line is a line beneath. So just bring in the country data. So when bring in the country data, so what are we trying to link both of them together? You can use country code, you can use country name. So let's use country code. Maybe use country code, you will notice that the selection matches 6,998 or 9,000 rules from the first table. Link fact farm to country data with the country code.
So you just click on country code.
Do you see one line here that has a job? You tell it that. So just click country code, country code.
Oh,
yes, the two, country code, country code.
Okay.
Do you notice that there's a mark down that says job, the selection? So now that selection means that everything that is here, all country that is here, is together with the all country that is here. But these are the data that are different. So that way you don't see it.
It's fine.
The selection matched. If the selection matched, did you remove the regions? Did you filter regions? In country data. So yes, in country data. Yes. So now you notice what he asked. Now he said if both of them are the same, and then they go to those. It means that you did not filter. So all the whole country that they don't have region is together with the fact file. So it's complete normally. But see, they don't have region, it's not the most problems.
Okay.
During analysis.
So we need to take them out.
We need to take them out.
That can create plans.
Yes.
Just uncheck.
Yes.
Okay.
And
it's
an opportunity to filter them and then hand it over to someone to go and find what the problem is, fix it, and
then you just jump in. So those 3,000 additions. That is where those data, that is where those things are missing. So that's why we need to clean. Because at the end of the day, when you are trying to do your allocate to your fact file, which is your reporting key, you are trying to link a table to a table in your model. It won't link up. Because that blank will be showing that it has multiple. So it will be saying many to many. Instead of many to one. So the same way is because all those countries are different. So there's nothing to link. So those further problems are very impossible to avoid. So let's see, okay.
So we need the joint kind, they're not changing anything.
No, there's nothing, no, just okay. So it comes in as a table. So if you look at this, beside the country data, you see two arrows. So open it. So now what we want to do with this is just that country code that we use to link both of them together, that other one should be tick, all other ones on tick. And okay.
What is the difference between distinct and unique?
Okay, so now if you're doing distinct count and unique count. So distinct count means that instead of separate, if you're doing so you have there's one analysis that we used to do. So let us say I'm trying to look at list of some departments, so HR,
finance,
operations. So now let us do blank. Which one is distinct? Which one is unique? The one that has data. Is one with these things. The one that has unique, one of them will be there.
So what?
Okay. So now this unique, this one, all of them are unique. Oh. But when it comes to this thing, means that I can get value for it.
Okay, so these things will be like three.
So we have
three. Yes.
Unique with our four unique. Oh.
So now, if you notice now, we have been able to clean the data. But there's another one issue with this fact file. We have to put in both columns.
Yeah.
Let's check.
You have some known rules in the fact just written down. You have some, it's supposed to be a
So we now have no.
So why did you bring in no rules?
Because that was the one we have.
Let me see. There are some blank
empty.
There are some blank rules then.
Yes. I will explain that.
Because those are the regions that we have taken out already from.
Which I wouldn't expect it to
No, to be, because the fact file still has those information. Okay. The countries are still in the fact file.
So now the first thing that you now do when you do this is not to remove the word, the law.
Yeah. Yeah.
So now we can do
take out the law, right?
Yeah, just take out the law.
Okay.
So it's not
full.
So they are about the same now, right?
Yeah.
So now we have two country codes. There is one country data, country code, there is the normal fact file. Now both of them are the same. They are not the same. So you just pick one to remove.
I think. can we remove the one we just fixed?
Yes, yes, yes. You can. Because now this is why you can't. All these are steps.
Okay.
You're not the step.
Okay.
So when you bring in a new data, it will still follow the step.
Okay.
So when you remove it, it still doesn't affect it.
So removing it doesn't mean that it will now release the data later.
You don't understand the steps.
So does it mean that when you bring in it, you inherit all the things that have been done to this data, just inherit everything and then apply it to it?
Yes. If you bring in a new data, you know how VBA works. Is it VBA or macros?
Macros.
The way macro works, the steps that you use, these are the steps.
Now, you should go the new data.
It will follow these steps. And what? Now, one more thing before we go. We've also made our break. So let's do one more thing before we go. That's the big break. So now, if you notice that every file is supposed to have a date calendar, every data, but we don't have.
Yes.
It's text. We have to convert it to. So let's look. We change it to date. Give it to what?
Dates.
But this one works. I mean, but it'll be another issue. It's not even months. We are waiting on year, we're not even on one. Now, when you tick dates in your visualization, because one thing about analysis is that you have to have your end goal in mind. So if we take dates now, we don't have here. If we take dates, it means that our table will show 01, 01, 01, 1970, 01, 01, 1971, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01, 01 will not be able to slice.
Yes. Yeah.
That is the only issue that we can do here is stable.
Okay.
So what should you do? Sir, can you set up because I remember you in fact.
Should we
move
on? Eh? Bring the columns.
You have 90 set close. You said bringing code up. So first of all, you are bringing code up. So can you change it back to here? Change it back to here first. Yes, I mean to text. So whenever you see add new step, do you see one add new step and current step? What's the meaning?
Okay, like you show.
New step, you build a new column.
Yeah.
Replacing it, replace the current one.
So now a new step will be that it's going to bring in a new step here.
Yes. Yeah.
So now what we want to do is add a new column. Whereby for every 2017 or 2016 or 1998, you must bring it as a date. That we want to do now. Whereby, you know, it is 20. Oh, it has already changed current. No, let me just move it. I want it to be year. Okay. So now I want to go by. He's saying 1970, but if you bring it as 101-1970. When you say 1992, we should bring it as 101. Now, you know, there's no month. So we assume our month is 1st of January. That we want to do now. So let's go to add columns. Add columns. So now there's a whole lot of analysis we can do here. But it's just one that we need, which is, if you want to create M language, you create it from custom functions. Yeah. M language. But now, what to do it from an example? Column from example, that's the one we work with. Column from example, make sure that you've selected here. Make sure you selected here, then click on column from example. From selection. Are we together? Who have this one for? Where is our answers? So, now, what you would now do is this. He's saying, give me an example since you've highlighted the column I want to use. So let's type O1. You notice, maybe you start typing O1. It's already giving you, it's already giving it for you. Slash 01, then you see slash 1970. So which one are you using?
It depends on the date type.
Yeah.
Mine is shown 131. So
131.
Maybe that's why.
Date type of your system.
Oh yes, 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 yeah, yes.
What's the order for me? So that means about type 1/1.
Yes, 1/1. Yes. So it works, Abby.
Yeah.
So click OK. So now you now notice now that there is now dates. There is dates. Everything is now settled. Now we're now fine. There is dates. There's now country data. But this one thing, you know that date we have to connect to another date. That is a D calendar on its own, that has only D calendar. As in, that has only calendar. It has days, I mean, it has year, months, everything, months number, all those things. So we'll go and do DAX. DAX. Yeah, DAX in PowerBI. For that.
Let's go.
Okay, so let's go on a break. We'll be using 10 minutes. 10 minutes. 10 minutes. 10 minutes.
Okay.
So I know that you have picked up PowerBI because at the end of the day, you notice that even from the high level management, there's a whole lot of reporting. Having visualization. People are tired of seeing numbers. Can I see a line and I understand how this is going? A trend line. I'm fine. The number, the percentage rates, okay, yes, we're going with this, that is, we know that is the technical side, but I want to make business decision. So if I see this, and if I see this coming down, give me an analysis of where I want it for, I want it down. I'm happy I was able to do analysis. It's not the right thing. So now let's go to Power BI. So let's go to home, close and apply. Both of them, you just do that, like both of them is me. So now we notice, we have to create that so that it's going to give us the day's calendar itself. Because we don't have this calendar. You have to create this calendar. So for everybody, can somebody give me that formula for this calendar? Let's start.
Yeah.
let's start. This is the lab where everybody's working. So first of all, what the manager says, first of all, new measure means we are trying to create a new DAX formula. If you go to modeling, make sure you are in data view, you have activity views, visualization view, data view, and relationship view.
Okay.
So make sure you are in data view, which is the real one.
Yeah.
So now, you can see new measure in modeling tab, new measure, new follow-up, and new table. New table means group of followers, new table with the phone. New column means a new follow-up in any of the table that you wish to. The new measure means normal, new, that calculation that you want to calculate. Now, what ones do you use here? Which one are we using?
New measure.
What creates a date calendar?
New table.
So let's pick new table. So what is the table name? Dates. So what is the code? What is the DAX function to create?
Calendar.
There's calendar, baby. Okay, so which one is it? That's. Okay, so let me explain what DAX is for people that just know there is something called DAX functions. So let me just give you lines about what DAX is. Now, the Power BI intelligence, Power BI has its own DAX. It has its own calculation that it gives to you. But for us to have control of these reports, then we are creating our own DAX formulas. Now, in DAX formulas, there are three major things that you have to measure. The first measure is outcome measure. Second measure is time intelligence. Third is variance. Now, the outcome measure is the baseline. Power BI calls it the baseline. We call it like, let me say, all other measures depend on that. measure and commercial. Now, if you notice in this of our analysis that we're doing, there's only one value that we have. Which value is that?
The number of passengers.
So if we add everything together, it gives us one value. That value itself, for everything that we're going to do, either year on year, or time intelligence, or variance, depends on that what? Number. That number itself is what we call the anchor measure. That value itself.
And the sum of all.
The sum of all. So sometimes it can be accounts. Sometimes it can be both. As far as everything will depend on it, for people you do actual budgets. The budget is an anchor. The actual is also an anchor itself. The sum. So we are trying to do variance of both of them year on year and everything like that. You are doing two different anchors. You are doing time variance for this, time variance for this, variance for this, variance for this. But at the end of the day, what we are saying anchor is that every other calculation depends on that anchor. Now, time intelligence is the one that we have every time series calculations. All time series. So, yesterday, previous year, previous months, year on year now is now percentage. If it's percentage, variance, you are comparing variance. But now this one is last year, previous year, months to days, year to days, quarters to days.
This month,
last month, last quarter, anything time series. Then why variance is now, variance is still an option of this. Because if you need a variance of last month, it means that current month over last month minus what? One. When you calculate this, change it into a format of what percentage. So it's still time. Time series. Current month, last month, time series. Then variance. So variance is trying to compare two. So that is just a brief description of how that's all. Now, there's something that doesn't make that's all. Everything that we're doing has to be filtered out. Which is, we're looking at how many passengers passed or used the air in sub-Saharan Africa or in Asia or in North America. All of them will give us different numbers. It has been filtered already. Now imagine now that we now want to modify that filter context. It's now the real function that we call the calculate function. The calculate helps us to modify every filter context. So there's a whole lot of, but as we go on, we're going to do it. So let's say this. For this, we have calendar. Calendar. We draw a table with one column of all dates between start date and end date. So we have. Now there are two things they ask us to do, to give. But I'm going to give a start date and what? End date. Start date and end date. But the ones whereby it has, like that's month year and months, day month year. When you have day month year, remember that we wanted to be in Power Query, but now you're going to say, so when you have day month year, so everybody click date, time date, date. So our start date is going to give us which year are we looking at now? 1970. Month 01. Day 01. Closes. Many closes, you notice that you answer the question of start date. Do your comma. Then end date is asked from you. Then you get it in. Then year, now our year is now 2018. 01, no. If you want to 2018, let's say it's the end of year. So 12, then 31.
Because it knows the
end. Yes.
as of now.
Yes.
The registration where you are putting in a query for the futuristic.
So just interesting to
Because I now to close open bracket and close bracket. That can be used for this as well.
Yes, yes, yes. So one is asking for specific city, one is asking for only a only bit.
But in Canada also now, what I have is fiscal year 8 months.
So
1970. Okay.
No, I don't know about that, but if you want to go in quarter, then that's
it. Yeah, it falls into. So you give two options.
Small,
close, or nice and
maximum. So everyone, if you are correct, the main thing now is that this is part of the intelligence needs.
Oh, okay.
So don't make sure you don't need the dates. So what you have to do is come up. So I'm going to tell you how you can do that whenever you're working on your data. So that's really about the dates, the dates, the months, and everything like that. So now our format, what are our formats need to do?
Yeah.
So I remember that again, yeah, why.
Yeah.
So put you have to do this first.
Yeah.
Why is this in quotes? Double quotation.
Is that the double quotation?
No. It's just normal. Format, open bracket, delete, okay. Double quotation, why. Double quotation, then close your bracket.
If I want possibly two
the month ahead.
No, not the month ahead. Same year, but I don't want to give the full year. I'm in the 90s. So I want to be 90s.
So three, put three what?
Now just as one.
Oh, okay. So now you got it works. So now this one tells you the full, so you write like monthly full. This tells you month. This gives you normal, but this is the one that we always use for format. This same thing gives you, so let's say June, same way to this, 1999,
capital small,
so, thank you for that question. For power query, it is case sensitive. Power query is case sensitive. So where you also put normal E, capital letter, you put E and small letter E.
So what?
Okay. So now I think we are fine. Let's go to the relationship, but let's be a relationship. Many to one,
Can I try?
Yes, come on. Why not?
I don't know how to put it, but I think that is when a lot of data comes. So in my head, I'm thinking of my contact list. Right? I have a phone number. Right? The relationship between my phone number and everybody in my contact involves many. Meaning that many people can have my number. Right?
Mm-hmm.
So that is one. That's what that data set that could mean that so many other contacts are mapped to several other contacts. So, for example, if everyone here has more than one contact of dbrownconsulting, it means that many people's numbers are mapped to many of dbrownconsulting. So, just to explain the relation between how data is mapped between each other, that's, I mean, I don't know if that exact example really helps.
No, yeah, fine. You still have an idea, Can I have a sense of?
Okay. For many to one, I think what that does is give you a unique number in one table, and which you're trying to check, for example, to let me look up, okay, our SAB number, this is the SAB, this is it, he joined this organization. So anytime I need to get information, anytime the number of SAB is in another table, I can easily use that master table to get
your link to the master table.
In addition, when we say many to one, or one to many, just the arrangement. For example, the student is registered in school, and you can pay school fees several times. On my school fees team, my name shows several times, because I keep paying every term or every semester. But on the other registration team, my
registration
is so that is one to many. Now, we also have cases where we have one to one.
Mm-hmm.
At the end of my program in that school, there is a team that is holding certificates. As long as I pass through the school, I can only take one certificate. Except maybe in the school that is doing one single program. If it's just one program, once they register me on the certificate, I also have one. Yeah, one entry. So that's one to one. So and the other one, many to many. Like, well, we have this rare
case.
But it's possible.
But it's possible. Yes. Very. Yes. For advanced level analysis. I'm still trying to forget that I have been to you. So he's saying that for many to many, maybe they have like three or four tables, and they have many to many relationship. Maybe I'll agree that our labs, you are going to get one. So yeah, Dinosaurs is a very good example of it. So for those who take our course here now, many of them have like many courses they take it, but their name is just one. So if I go to the database and type Mr. Dabo now, with a sunny name, as I'm typing that, I'm already bringing it out. I will just click on it and see the number of courses they are taking for so many years that they have been taking passing course. So that it is. So now you notice that one of the table has unique. One of the table has many repeated. So now let me explain it to you. The one that has many is the fact file. So fact file will always grow. So you remember, at that time you can have another data that can even give us the 1960 to 1969 data. It can give us, and from there we still look at it. So that is, it will always grow, our fact file will always grow. Always grow. Because normally, we now don't have 2018 data. By next year, we'll have, if you update it, what we're going to do is just refresh and jump itself. So that is many to one. Now that one is now the date table that we just created using DAPS. It's coming once. Every day, one, it's not updated.
It's really,
and it's unique.
So if you have 2019 data, this will not work for it.
For 2019, the total of volumes is calculated auto. So it's growing automatically. So it depends on your reports that you want to do. If you know that your report is not something that you want to do some analysis, fine. But if you know that it's just straight up, you can do your reports to calendar auto. So now, is anybody here now?
Is it
ready
to one or
should it be ready
to one?
Ready
to one.
Yes. Okay, go to PowerBI, check your dates calendar. I mean, check your dates. If it is, check the data type. You can have check from here. Check the data view, go to data view, check the data type of dates. Go to far, check the data type. So this, you don't, okay, this is data type, so why not connect? So try and look at it. So now, the first thing that I want to build is to have our anchor measure. So how do we get an anchor measure? So in the next, so let me do the, I am going to just create the data. So there are things that I want to create. So first of all, what is the data? The first data I want to do is an anchor measure. The sum total of all the number of passengers across time. So let's call it total number first, that is the anchor measure. Now for time intelligence, what is the time intelligence that I want to create?
Highest amount that people travel.
There are 2 months.
2 months of decades.
Decades.
10 years.
Okay, so that is 10 years. 10 years in total.
Yeah, so in that instance, you probably want to see year with some unique natural disaster. This is what happens.
Okay. And which one did you
hear? 19th century and 20th century.
So that is So now, I might want to look at the average year, the average in each region.
For each year.
For different years.
Okay. Are we giving you any intelligence now? Yeah. We're doing intelligence examples here.
This is the time that it is very nice.
Okay, so.
Anyone that is giving me, yes, anyone.
You do region. If something happens in a particular region, that means reduction in travel. So you want to do a trend on region by number of people that travel in a particular year.
Region by number of people. That one, you made a good region and revenue. It's also giving the number of people.
Oh, well, you can't go.
Oh, I don't get it.
No, what you said, what is it again?
If I think region now, I think region. And I think go to my part and I think this. You also give me.
Oh, okay, so what are the examples you want, the things that are going to use that to make?
Thank you.
Okay, what about this? You want to see how a particular country, you know, move from probably the lowest segment to become the topmost.
The topmost?
Yeah.
Okay.
So you want to see when did that happen?
within 1 second period.
Okay. So we have
after the
growth this one here, scatter chart. Now, this one is going to do. We are looking at this, and we are looking at, let's say, why this has to do with the number of people. Then this is here. And we are using the election that has to do with the different regions. So now, that means possible to also have like 7 regions that is scattered in this visualization. So now for every year that it moves, because we're going to do that now, something will come play as it is. So now for every time that it moves and every year that it's growing, the growth rate is being shown for every region. I think that's what you're saying.
Let me jump. There is this visualization I saw earlier when you are ranking countries by year, GDP growth per year.
You saw it on the screen?
No, it's not popular.
Amazon was growing year.
Exactly.
So that's the only thing I have is if you look at the data, I don't know why this is not true. That's formula that I want us to do first, then we'll do it. So under any factor which is our tasks, we can do quick measures. We'll go and we'll see quick measures. Instead of writing this for that formula, we'll use quick measures. But for some, we have to do the entire. So then, but then also, when we get to that point, we can create the tasks to do that as well. So all this that we'll use, let us do them first. Let us do them first. So, now the first one is our anchor version. So now, let's go and create new measure. Then we're looking at sum total. So, sum total is
in.
Okay,
I think that you mentioned you created in PowerBI LiveLab. column.
So now, if you want to do some open brackets, now we're going to file, then go to mail up your number of packages. As far as your blue, that blue line is sticked on the column that you're looking for, tab and close. Tab and close. Enter. So now what you just do, I've never created any visualization. Okay, so what you just do is create a bring in Richard. Just see Richard. You're going to bring in the table visualization. Tick in Richard. Go to your bank file, bring in the number of people carried that we have that value. Then tick in the sum total, you know that we just see. Both of them must have the same value. Richard value, which is the number one that has E, solution E in FAFA. Then bring in the that calculation ability now. And the DAS ability. Yes.
That's calculation. So do it again.
not double check.
I have to say this.
You couldn't connect to your primary source. So check that it's fine and correct. So that you check what you check. Check that it's good. So let's move very fast. So we have limited time. So now if you want to, I can see.
Yes.
So now don't just format to put it format. So that let's rush. Now we want to double that measure. Now we are looking at last year. Let's just look at last year. So last year.
What format is that you select the on the
tip on the calculation itself, the DAX. When you tick it, go to modeling tab.
Okay.
Can you see this? Did it work?
Yes.
Okay. So last year, it was to $90 times the that are going to be the variety of contests. So now what you will do is this for that.
I need to check it before.
Okay.
Whenever I take a calculate, I want to modify the filter.
Yes.
So the filter is
same. Okay, so then we set up filter. Is that the same? Is that the same? So let me increase this. Let me use this as an explanation. Okay, so I think it's going to be very simple. Okay, so now see, I want that filter contest. The total is 70 billion.
Is it?
Yes, 70 billion. Yeah. Of the number of people from 1970 to 2018. Mm-hmm. Now, when we did this filter, when we just click revenue, if you click cash and you click sum total, what will you bring up? It will bring what? So let me do that. So I think that you get it right now. So this is card visualization, and I see sum to sum. 70 billion.
Yeah.
Now, 70 billion. And you're my boss, and you tell me that 70 billion, I know. But in which regions? What will you do? You do this. Why do you know this?
That's
a
theory.
What? It means that the filter. You will follow me now.
Yes.
This is filter.
Yes, okay.
Now, we are like, okay, fine. But can you give me the percentage at which we arrived? Like, we have 16 million for East Asia. So what is the percentage for here to this?
It's a percentage difference between
one region versus the total region among times only gamma. Now, that is where you're now thinking of calculates. Because you're saying calculates that are calculates. See, all these filters that I'm adding, either in time series or in region or anything, don't look at them. Mm-hmm. Modify it. I want to modify it. This filter contest. Now, these two things, I want to modify it. To do what is the next question. That I notice that you need to give us two calculates. The first thing you need to ask you is your expression.
Yeah.
For those who use calculates, your expression. The expression means that what is the main thing you want to break down, you want to analyze. Which one of the examples you use our anchor measure.
Yeah.
Now, when you put the anchor measure, the next question is that what do you want to filter?
Yeah.
what do you want to modify? Which filter pattern do you want to modify? Then you now to define, I want to modify something. I want to modify the time, date, year, or I want to modify the region. I want to modify anything in your report you want to do. You understand? The first thing is this, all cars. If you bring you one car, it gives you the figure. Yeah. Now this figure, I now want what? I now want to filter it.
Some context
to it, that is now the filter context.
Yeah.
Now in this filter context that I have put to it, this figure or this car, now I now want to modify it. Is it going to be the car?
Okay.
But when you saw that, I had a contribution, I appreciate it. Okay. So now let's imagine you want to look at the percentage for each region. Now, what we will do is create a new measure. Now, the new measure we want to do now is here in Excel. You need to have. Can I get this difficult? Okay.
I got those 540 billion.
They have 470 billion.
There is 1 lakh.
470. 1 lakh. That's what I'm talking
about. 1 lakh.
Yeah. So now, are you seeing where I want us to go to? That's so. It is mapping. So now. Yes, region. So you want to country data.
The region.
So now, once you do a calculation that says that either I put card or I filter it, give me 70 billion. Notice, the first thing we did was card, 70 billion. When we did with filter, it broke down to this. But once you do a calculation that says that I break or I don't break, give me what? The value 70 billion. So even though I filter it, you will still be giving me what? 70 billion. If you tell me that each station is 16 billion, that is the calculation we want to do now. Very fast. So what we want to do, we use calculate. So now let's call it passenger total. Something for us to do. Passenger total.
It's a measure.
Yes, it's a measure. Imagine, if you want to calculate, evaluate the context modified by filter, evaluate the expression modified by filter, tab the expression, what are we using? Sum total that we just created now, the data that we created, the amount of measure that we will be using. Sum total. So now, which filter that we don't want it to look at anymore? So that we have to create a filter that we filter. So but now we need a function that will say that see Asia, Africa, as I'm passing through, I don't want to look at the name, but I want to look at the values. So pick values, don't pick the name. Now what we want to do. So now the function is all. All. Everybody all. All return to rule. Then now we go to the now which data are we using? Country data region. Country data region. Close it twice. So now, make sure.
I'm trying to process it in English.
What does that mean? I think that the total is the total of all passengers per region.
Yes.
That's what we did before.
Yes.
Now we're saying, hey, go into that someone that I created, that has total of everybody in every region. Right? And then go into, say, all countries in that region. Then they go into that region as well. And then you give the total.
Yes. So you know what you do? Make sure that this one is seats. This is the seat. This is your lecture. And tick the journey that I'm going to do is now. You're using for photos.
So what
are
the
capital? Passage total.
Passenger.
And then some total. Yes.
They're
equal. Now, did you get this now?
Yeah. Oh, you want me to put it in the same?
Okay.
No, so what is
yours? Yes.
Okay, this is giving all the total throughout.
Throughout.
Online, individual.
Online, individual. So what I'm saying is that for every region, don't look at the region. Just give me the value associated with that region.
Also, can I use that to the percentage?
Thank you.
Just for months.
So now let's see since the virus are popping up. for the total of the past 40 years, does not
make sense. It was giving the number.
Exactly, yeah. 1% compared to Euro, not America, it's standard. If you before leave, So now where you that sort of like where you work, let's imagine that in 1980 Sub-Saharan Africa was 1.3% and by 2018 it went to 23%. Visualization will work for that. That line chart will still work for that. Because it's growing. For every year it's growing. So it's what but I think that when you notice, I think that if you look at the year different, year on year, you notice that all of them are actually moving at the pace of industrialization. So for every new for since 1980, if you look at the different years, you notice that it is a very different year, the first region, that are very green where there is more progressing movement. There is no overtaking. It is when they are taking that visualization will make sense. And then like, for people who do that on LinkedIn, they prefer to do it with sports, clubs. Those clubs, where they say Arsenal or Man U, I won right from time, maybe after 5 matches, they are losing, they started getting beginning points. When you use that data, it does go up. And you want the all the companies like that are so low, and go to the other.
Okay.
And that is the infrastructure, So now, let's go, we have to be very fast, we have to still leave now. So now, the next thing I want to look at is last year, previous year. So let's do that structure of previous year. Previous year. So for previous year, what do you think we should do? First, what is the first concept we use for previous year? Modifying all years. Same period last year is second concept. That same period last year is depending on what meaning. Yes, it's many of these. It's time to get it. Second thing is what? If I say that we made the revenue of 80 million, and I say give me 7 million last year, you're giving me 7 million last year function, what is the main thing you have to use to make sure you give me that it is 2 million? That I made last year, or take it from last year. Thank you, sir. That is the annual measure. So now let's do the calculate the expression itself is the sum total. They are filtered by the same period last year. This is. Okay. So I just wanted to show you something here. I don't want you to have this thing coming up. So let me just show you from. Let me show you how to do that. Don't leave it there. Let me just show you how to do that. I'll come back. Let me just show you. Let me just see. Now, we have the other thing with updates. Those are the other ones we move with. So I go to data lab. But I'm not to data that I make sure that I'm actually in the date table. They give up in the date table. Do you see mark as date table?
Yeah.
Then mark it as date table.
My class is a where is that?
The last, second to the last.
go to modeling. Map as daily table. Give this map as daily table.
Yeah.
Go to the ability act of a select photo.
Yeah.
Then click this. If you click this, it will ask you, you will tell me that I'm validated successfully. Click OK. So let's go back. So let me bring it to that. So you see how it works now. Glasses here. Then we have the calculators.
Sum total,
comma, same period last year. Then you have your days. This is the same. You do that every minute. So it means that for everyone here, if I'm 2017, you should give me that for 2016. That is the definition. Sum total, calculate the sum total, comma, same period last year, then the date.
So you notice that I need to click
if and tab and open your bracket, you need to bring logic number and logic number 2. It means that the first logic, which is the first data that is available, second logic means second data that is available. So, logic number 1 is sum total. Sum total. Logic number 2 is last year. Divided by last year, the minus 1. Close the bracket. And it's up.
It is sort of the previous year. That's if sort of the previous year.
Is that the
reason? Is that the
reason? Is that the reason? Give me variance.
The variance is now the sort of the
for this year.
For this year. Mm-hmm. Right, right, right. For last year.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. Okay.
So now, everybody goes back to make sure you hold up. I don't know that before you see share the last one for this share, that is the one that you are going to PowerBI services. But before that, do you see where I want you to go to? Do you see new measures?
Yeah.
The third one?
Yeah.
Okay, please. Now this one makes us fast again. Select is calculation. So let's select average power category. Average power category. The number selects which category we're looking at, which are they were looking at the base value is our anchor, which is sum total. But when you look okay, you see that the right is that formula already.
Wait.
We are looking at average per category. Any category that we're looking at. So now the first thing is that the actions are baseline. A baseline is one of the things that I want to use to when you find a data pocket that we're doing. A baseline is our anchor measure. Baseline. Anchor measure. So which one is our baseline here? Some of the factors. So John is there. John and John.
That's what I mean.
That's what I mean. The baseline and the base value. The base value is you can draw.
Oh,
then. You measure. Not the trying to. So now, They still want you to use their own date. That does it. They still want you to use their own. So it doesn't work. So they tell you about it, they tell you it doesn't work. But I think those category calculation works. Let me tell you, make sure that I did those type of calculation works. I will give the alcohol. Then you can have it. So now, for the next like 10 minutes, I will create a dashboard with visualization. So we have our variance, we have people that we need. So let me show you, what I created. So please, we have to read it. Let's do it. So any visualization, just try and look at your visualization and work with it.
Oh, okay. So some tools are previous.
Okay, so it's not really showing that one because of the screen. So what I was able to do is, I changed my slicer into what we call play slicer, which is for every 5 seconds, changed in space of those 40 years. And you notice that it's directing all that we're not affecting this. Do you notice? It's not changing, this one is not changing. So I make sure that the slider, I pick the slider, it's something they call interaction. In fact, yeah. So you pick one that you interact with. So that's what I did. And then it's changing. So that one, then I created slicers for the difference of the income group that you said. I created a slicer for that, for the income group. And I said, define for every year that happens, who are the best in the top 10, in the top 5, top 6, which is the one I created here. And if you notice,
they are changing,
this one is changing. But some of them are not changing because they are constant, but they are growing too. So it might be yeah that some of them have changed, if you notice, but not all of them have changed because the numbers are growing. But I think the United States will still grow with the years. I think it will still grow like that. So this is just time series. You bring in, you can bring in the logos, you can change, and this slides out. So that's what I just did. But I want you to create your visualization, your self. Yes, Google doesn't know that. That's what you want to create.
Okay.
That's what you want to
create.
Okay, you start creating.